if you get it right, your metabolism will go faster and faster and faster and faster. Okay, if you get it right.
Okay.
If you get it wrong, it will be going the other way. Some of the signs we've been looking for when your metabolism goes fast is you eat a meal and you get hot. Okay, and certain foods are more thermogenic than other foods. Do you remember a few weeks ago, me and Chloe was like telling you how much to eat, and you were like, what, that much? Eat that? Yeah. And we're like, no, you need to eat loads, Ben. You need to eat any. And it's almost counterintuitive because you're dieting for a show and you think, what are you eating this for? Well, this is the carb cycling diet. This is the nature of it.
Yeah.
Is that refeed has to be substantial. If those refeeds aren't substantial enough and then you go straight back into another carb cycle, all that's going to happen is your body's going to adjust, your body's going to adapt.
Yeah.
And the way it's going to adapt is it's going to start to slow your metabolism down. Signs of high testosterone are increased sex drive.
Yeah.
When your testosterone's high and you're healthy, you should at the very least have an erection for a few hours in the morning, especially when you wake up. Right, let's get to the nuts and bolts of where we are with everything. We talked about the main hormones involved in getting your metabolism going fast, the ones you want to keep high, the ones you want to keep low, how to manipulate them, etc. Now, you've kind of got to the stage now, and where you are is typical of many people that do a show, and they've got this like focused mindset on the show, but underlying that is actually a lot of uncertainty and a lot of like what would be termed anxiety, but not like anxiety, it's almost like an excitement anxiety. They're like getting on it, doing what they need to do, and it's almost like it's a type of stress, but it's not recognized as a type of stress.
Okay.
Because it's considered excitement. Hmm. But it is a kind of anxiety, as it were, underlying, which is all perfectly normal, perfectly natural. When you're natural, it's very easy to drop in testosterone.
Okay.
And the things that do that, as you know, just overtraining when you're natural. Slightly. Of course, when you're getting ready for the show, you're in the mentality, oh, I need to train more.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? Mm. And that's one of the mistakes people make running up to a show, training naturally, is they train harder and harder and harder. As you get closer to the show, their sex drive disappears and their fucking testosterone goes. They're feeling good in one way because without realizing it, they've actually got a lot of like stress hormones rising in their body. Mm. So they've got a lot of buzz about. And they're buzzing for it, but they don't have that relaxed, fucking confident, arrogant, high testosterone charge. From what you've said, in the last week, is it, or the last couple of weeks, you've started to notice your tests start to drop a little bit?
Yeah, it doesn't feel like it's high.
No, you know when it's high. When it's high, on a day like this, you'll walk down the high street and you'll be looking around at every woman that catches your eye. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's so hard to tell, though, because there's such a difference in energy from being on no carbs. And, you know, I've adapted to the way that feels. And it's really hard to know what's the cause or the reason for, you know, how I'm feeling at any given moment, you know?
Yeah. What you mean, the idea of having no carbs and getting used to what that feels like versus having carbs for energy, it feels different, you mean?
Yeah, but I'm saying like testosterone, you know, I'm on no carbs, I got less energy, and so it's hard for me to pinpoint, like, have I got less testosterone or have I just got less energy? It's hard to say.
Okay, well, like in the videos we've done in the past, like signs of high testosterone are increased sex drive, increased like determination. Your attitude when your testosterone is high is very different. It's much more risk taking. It's much more I don't give a shit. It's much more go get. It's much more powerful, manly, aggressive.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
When you I mean, when your testosterone's low, you haven't got a constant erection all night long.
Yeah.
When your testosterone's high and you're healthy, you should at the very least have an erection for a few hours in the morning, especially when you wake up. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I get that. I got that. I got a better Jada.
Okay. So your testosterone is not too bad then?
Yeah. No, I got plenty of that kind of arousal. Yeah.
Good. So what the feeling you've got then is probably from the low carbs.
Right. That makes more sense. Yeah.
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 And because of your body's not done this before, and your body type would probably need more carbs than the average person. From what you've told me, it sounds like your metabolism is slowing slightly.
Okay.
The things that get the metabolism going, I mean, do you remember a few weeks ago, me and Chloe was like telling you how much to eat, and you were like, what, that much? Eat that? Yeah. And we're like, no, you need to eat loads, Ben. You need to stuff face today. You need to eat pizzas, ice creams, chocolates, cakes, rice. You need to just eat and eat. You need to, and you're like, what? That sounds, and it's almost counterintuitive.
Yeah.
Because you're dieting for a show, and you think, what are you eating this for? Well, this is the carb cycling diet. This is the nature of it.
Yeah.
Is that refeed has to be substantial. If those refeeds aren't substantial enough, and then you go straight back into another carb cycle, all that's going to happen is your body's going to adjust. Your body's going to adapt.
Yeah.
And the way it's going to adapt is it's going to start to slow your metabolism down. But this is all learning. You've never done this before.
Right.
You're not. Everybody has different talents and skills. I would say that one of your talents and skills is being able to be logical and to plan things and to be kind of like in that kind of place.
Yeah.
Whereas some people are absolutely crap at that stuff, but they're really good at tuning in and feeling things. Do you know what I mean? Other people, they have to experience it a lot,
yeah,
and go through the ranges of doing it too much that way, too much that way, before they get the middle ground.
Yeah, that's more like me, isn't it?
It's more like you. Yeah. So, from what you've told me, I would say your metabolism is slowing down. We need to get that speeding up. We haven't got much time left. That if for your reference, that's due to not having enough on refeed days. But you can't quickly overcompensate for that. Do you know what I mean? So next refeed day, yeah, eat a bit more than last time, push it a little bit further, but you can't eat tons and tons and tons and tons and tons, expect to make up for like 4 or 5 weeks of not eating enough on refeed day. Does that make sense?
Right, yeah.
Because your body, you're shifting your body slowly over time.
Yeah.
So you can't suddenly go, oh, let's just quickly get back up again. But we can certainly make sure that tomorrow's your refeed day, isn't it?
No, the day after.
The day after. So fifth day off tomorrow, sixth day will be your free feed day on the day after. Right, okay. Yeah. And the signs you're looking out for as well, which haven't really been coming in as strong as they should have been, which again is a sign of your metabolism going a bit slower rather than faster, is your hunger hasn't really been going high, has it? Today you're on day four of your zero carbs?
Yeah.
Eating clean, and you're doing your walking, you're doing your cardio, you've been training, so you've been very active. You're not eating a huge amount of food. Your calories are low.
Yeah, around about 2,000, I reckon.
Yeah, which is really quite low.
Okay.
So by 4 days of no carb, I mean, after 2 days of no carbs and on about 3,000 calories with no carbs, by day three, I'll be absolutely screaming at the wall for a couple of pizzas and some real dense carby cheat food.
Oh no, I've never felt that. No.
It's a sign of tuning in and going, oh, okay, right. Well, as this cycle's going on, metabolism actually seems to be going slower, not faster. Why is that? Okay, and it's going to be the thing is, what people do, this is the mentality what people do when get ready for show, and I've done it myself. I did it on my last show. I hadn't done a show for about 9 years, and then I did a show, and I'd forgotten a lot of things, and I kind of got closer and closer, and I did the classic work harder, almost slight air of panic coming in, more cardio, and I ended up slowing my metabolism right down, and it's very easily done. is very, very easily done. Because remember, your body doesn't know that you're dieting for a show. Mm. All your body knows is what it's coming in and what's happening to it. That's all your body knows.
Yeah, I see.
So as far as your body's concerned, you're starving.
Yeah, yeah.
And things are getting pretty hectic in the environment. Like, we must be foraging for food every fucking day because we're eating less and we're walking more.
Right.
We need to make sure we survive this.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Does that make sense? And it's a weird thing to get, Ben. If you've never done like carb cycling and if you've never had a refeed day and you've never eaten those kinds of foods, and it does sound counterintuitive.
Yeah, very. That's the one thing that's been most resistant in my mind, I think. The idea of eating loads on a refeed day. I really struggled to get that. And on the last one, I ate loads. But previously to that, I really struggled to accept that I have to eat more.
Because you were showing us what you were eating. Like, is that all he's eating? Why is he not eating more than that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it is. This is your learning curve, man.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's the first time I've done all this, isn't it? It's all completely new.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And you've chosen to do it a way where you learn something that stays with you for the rest of your life. You could have taken like an easy route. You could have gone to a dietitian and you could have paid to have a planned diet, and every week you would have sent them pictures, every week they would have measured your body fat, every week they would have made small adjustments in your food would have been very bland and very boring, and but it would have all been calculated for you, and you could have done that, but you wouldn't have learned anything. You would have got to the end of the show and you would have looked good and you would have done your bit, but then you would have gone back to normal and you would have learned nothing about your body. You would have learned nothing about metabolism going fast, nothing about leptin levels dropping, nothing about ghrelin levels. You wouldn't have known these things until you start playing around with it.
Yeah, yeah, got you. So the last refeed day, I feel like I ate plenty. I was full all day. I was eating all day, pizza, ice cream, the whole lot.
Much better refeed day that was, man. Much better, wasn't it? Well, tell me how you felt the day after in terms of like.
Yeah, you know, I've heard you talk repeatedly about muscle fullness and feeling depleted, and I've never really experienced any drastic difference between the two, really. You know, not that was ever so noticeable.
Okay. When you're training at the moment, let me ask you a question. You're pumping, you're doing high reps, and you're training as high intensity as you can in, for where you are.
Yeah.
Are you getting a big pump? Are you getting a big burn, or are you finding that you're having to do loads and loads and loads and not a lot is happening?
Yeah, I am getting a burn. I am getting a pump, but it doesn't seem to be as much without the carbs. Does that make sense?
As it was about a month or two ago, yeah?
Yeah, so like, I'm finding it harder to get that pump and burn. It's like I got to really, really push it and really, really focus just to get a little bit of pump. Whereas on a carb day, like last time I was down the gym with you, we were doing arms and that was my carb day. And it seemed to be much easier to push it. Is that normal? Is that?
Yeah, that's just a sign of your depleted.
Okay.
If you're low on glycogen, it takes a lot longer to get a pump. And it doesn't blow up as much, doesn't burn as much. You just don't get that real tight exploding feeling in the muscle.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that's how I've been feeling. Yeah, I've been struggling to get that pump. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Well, I'm today, in terms of hunger and in terms of cravings, how are you feeling?
Well, I've got plenty in me so far because I have my protein. I started with my whey yogurt, you know, whey powder yogurt and some nuts in there. I then had a load of water, I had a tin of tuna, so I've been eating, so I don't feel hungry.
Okay, cool, yeah. Cool. What I'm going to suggest is for this afternoon and this evening, you add in some complex carbs.
Okay.
And start to refill a little bit, and I'm going to suggest that we shift your cheat day forward a day so that you have it tomorrow. So start eating some complex carbs, some sweet potatoes, stuff like that. Brown rice is really good. Just start adding some of that in this afternoon and this evening.
Okay, so day three, a little bit of complex carbs. Day four, a full carb day.
Just for today, because I know you from what you've said, from what I can tell, you are a bit carb depleted, you are a bit flat, and your metabolism is going this way a little bit rather than this way.
Right, yeah, so we need to sort of stoke the fire.
Stoke fire, that's it. Yeah. Now, the other thing that happens, like I said, running up to a show and people's metabolisms slowing, if you get it right, your metabolism will go faster and faster and faster and faster. Okay, if you get it right.
Okay.
If you get it wrong, it will be going the other way. This way is more like an anxiety, fear-based kind of like, let's do more, let's try harder. This way is more of a, like, which very few bodybuilders get to, normally for champions, normally the top bodybuilders, they can tend to get to that, where they just don't care. They just kind of know. They're so certain, and they're so confident. Their minds are so set that it's more of a relaxed walk into winning a show. Do you know what I mean? As opposed to a try. Do you know what I mean?
I'm with you.
Doing lots of cardio, putting more intensity in when you're training, doing more, all those things actually can tire you out. So although rest and recovery is massively important, as you know, for building muscle and bone fat, right now at this stage, it's even more crucial that when you rest, you're really rested. And when you relax, you actually can relax deeper. So if you've got any friends that do massage, anything like that, I know it sounds silly, it doesn't sound like it would do much, but trust me, Ben, if you can have a massage tonight or tomorrow night and you can go to a deeper level of relaxation, that's going to really help your hormones, that's going to help your metabolism.
Okay.
Because then in the morning, in the daytime, you're active, you're busy. Make sense?
Yeah. Yeah. So there's like a sweet spot where the metabolism, you're just getting it just right, you're eating the right things at the right time, and it's like if you go too far either way, like dieting too hard, it slows down, or if you go the other way, like too many calories, that has the wrong effect too.
Yeah. I mean, some of the signs we've been looking for when your metabolism goes fast is you eat a meal and you get hot. Your body starts to get hot. Okay, and certain foods are more thermogenic than other foods. And like if you haven't had carbs for a few days and your metabolism is running fast, as soon as you start eating carbs, you'll be sweating.
Yeah, I've never had that.
You've never had that yet. Never, yeah, never. I know this. But this is your learning curve. You wouldn't ever go to this extreme in trying to play with this stuff unless you had a show.
Yeah, absolutely. Never. Yeah. You don't know what you don't know, do you?
It's absolutely true. You don't know what you don't know. Yeah, definitely.
So if we bring the carbs, if we get some carbs in me, I'll be able to train a bit harder in terms of. That'll be an advantage as well, will it?
Oh, well, yeah, as you know, training intensity, training volume, weights lifted, is going to increase your hormone production positively. So more testosterone, more growth hormone, more et cetera, et cetera. I mean, it's like in the last few weeks, been doing a bit more cardio. If you can, it's better if you can do as little as cardio as possible. Do you know what I mean? If you can actually get away with like just doing cardio a couple of times a week and still lose fat, that's great. You're going in the right direction. Do you know what I mean? Sometimes when people try and think the answers are to do more, very often that's what chucks them back in the wrong direction.
That's what I've been doing, isn't it? I've been walking every day.
Yeah. I would have a day off. Just relax, man. You get some complex carbs in you later on today. Have a couple of portions and show me what you're doing. Tomorrow, have a bit of a cheat day. Are you training tomorrow?
Yeah.
Cool, great. What are you training?
I could do back if I wanted.
A nice big muscle group. Right, so you're going to have a good feed-in for breakfast, good feed-in pre-workout. You're going to have good feed-in tonight, complex carb-wise. So there's no reason, and you're going to make it a priority to relax deeper than normal tonight.
Okay.
So tomorrow, you can then go in with that back session, and you can fucking have a real test boosting back session, and again go straight back to relaxation as soon as you can, as deep as you can.
I can really feel that I haven't, now that we talk about it, I haven't had intense workout since, hang on, let me think about what I'm trying to say here. What I'm trying to say is, because I'm spending so much time on no carbs, my workout intensity is less. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah,
your glycogen levels are low, man, by the sounds of it, and from looking at you, you need and it's simply because you're learning to tune in for refeeding.
And it's
almost shocking for you how much of a refeed you have to have. Do you know what I mean? Last refeed day was the best refeed day you had. This refeed day will be even better.
Got it.
The other thing is, quickly run through supplements, just want to check ZMA. No. Night time, sleeping.
Calcium and magnesium. Is that any use or is that not it?
That's not it. You need zinc and magnesium, ZMA. You should be taking that like right now because you're obviously training hard and you're pushing your body. You need ZMA pretty much. You're going to need it every night, man.
Oh, hang on. Wait a minute.
I think you have got it.
Wait a second. It says, just let me read it to you. Calcium, magnesium, substrate with D, and then it says plus potassium, zinc, and magnesium.
Oh, right. Okay. That might be the right ratios. If you want to double check, go online to any supplement store. There's zinc and magnesium. Look at the ratio of magnesium, vitamin B6, and zinc.
Okay.
There's a particular ratio.
Is there?
And by the sounds of it, what you've got there might be okay. You're taking that every night, every day?
Yeah, I am, pretty much. Yeah.
Yeah. I need you to check the dosage of magnesium, zinc, and B6 there.
Does it help if I read it out to you now, or should I just?
No, because I can't remember the ratios and dosage amounts. You need to check that against the recommended dosage of ZMA, because okay. ZMA is specific amounts of those ratios of minerals, and you take those before you go to bed. You're going to have a deeper sleep. You're going to have better hormone production.
Yeah.
And it's just going to really help you at this stage. But that's a standard one. But get on that.
Magnesium, potassium, zinc. Yeah. Okay, all right, I'll get on that, yeah.
Calcium. The other thing is, you're a natural bodybuilder. You need to take advantage of what you've got, being natural. So you need to make sure that you can boost your testosterone by different means. You're doing well with your diet in terms of, like, having an avocado a day, monosaturated fats. You're having eggs pretty much every day, good cholesterol in there, flaxseed oil. So you've got some good quality fats and saturated fats, and you're having some saturated fats on meat, but a small amount. So you're having enough fat in your body to produce testosterone, because that's another thing people do. They cut the fat right down, and it's proven over and over and over again, once you drop down to a certain level of saturated fat and good fats, that your body will just slow down its testosterone production.
Okay. Yeah, I've cut the eggs out. Do I need to get them back in there?
Yeah, man. Yeah, I didn't know that. Yeah, keep the eggs in, man. Yeah, the egg yolks. This is why, look at Michael Hearn, what he does with his diet. His diet is actually quite high in fat.
Yeah.
He understands the importance of that for your hormone productions.
Yeah, I've never heard a bodybuilder say eat less fat.
I mean, you don't want to be like deliberately going out your way trying to eat loads of fatty foods, and you want to keep your fats to certain types of fats, monosaturated fats. A little bit of saturated fat is good for you. Cholesterol, egg yolks, brilliant for your testosterone production. Right. Omega-3 is massively important. You're going to get plenty of omega-6s because you eat lots of nuts and seeds. But just making sure that you're getting a decent amount of that in your diet every day, that's going to help keep your hormones high.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. There's one thing that we have cleared up. I thought I was eating too much, but by the sounds of it, 2,000 calories, even with nuts in there and avocado in there, and the
you're walking, you're training, you're young.
That ain't a lot, is it? That ain't a lot of calories. Okay, because that's been a point of confusion, isn't it? Because we weren't sure if I was eating too much.
Yeah, when you said that today, I thought, nah, he's definitely, your metabolism's definitely doing that. Other supplements, deer aspartic acid. This is a very powerful testosterone booster. As far as I'm aware, there's no issues with that on natural bodybuilding shows, but that's a must.
Okay, is that the sort of thing you can just get in the shop, or is that myprotein.com?
Depends on which shop. You'll get it in GNC, but MyProtein does it as well, and all the big stores do it. Maca is good if you're a bit run down, a bit tired, slightly low. It's again, that helps, that nourishes the hypothalamus. So again, that I find that works with other supplements well to help keep your hormones high. Have you got Maca?
No, I haven't. I've heard you mention it. No, I just didn't get round to getting it.
Okay, ginseng.
No, same again. I've heard you mention it, but
and put your hand out. Let me give you a slap.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Mate, you need to get on this. You got 2.5 weeks left. As far as I'm aware, because we've done all the videos on all this stuff, I assumed you had this all in stock and you was already on all that. But those things make a big difference, man. Because at the moment, you're stressing your body. Your body's under stress, like I've explained. Your body doesn't know what you're doing. As far as it's concerned, you're running out of food and you're trying really hard to get more. So it is a type of stress. It is, your body is more stressed now than it was a couple of months ago. So things like ginseng help your body adapt to stress. It will actually really elevate your energy levels. Same with maca. Get your maca, get your ginseng in you, go get some D-aspartic acid, check your ZMA.
Because
people don't realize this, but supplements make a massive difference. If you're training properly, you're eating properly, supplements really supplement what you're already doing. And just because they're natural, just because they're herb based or they're natural based, doesn't mean they're not effective. Put them together, start using them intelligently. They make a big difference, man. So ask, watch the interviews, type in Michael Hearn supplements. It'd be the first one to come out. He said, I'm really big on my supplements. I love supplements. Yeah. I take loads. All of them do. All the top natural bodybuilders.
From maca and ginseng, eBay. Can I get that on eBay?
Yeah, get eBay. Yeah, man.
Okay,
yeah.
All right. Yeah.
Yeah. All that stuff you should be able to get in town, but it's probably going to be more expensive.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Just to summarize what we said, so instead of the 5-day no carbs and then day 6 carb up, we're going to bring that forward a day. So on day 4, I'll start having complex carbs. On day 5, we'll bring the carb day forward a day.
Yeah. Today, I want you to have at least, for example, 200 grams of brown rice and another 150 grams of, say, sweet potato, etc. Have a couple of complex carb portions in. Have one perhaps maybe this afternoon, and then maybe one later on this evening.
Yeah,
Have some clean meat with that, chicken, etc. Have some vegetables with that. Have you been juicing at all recently?
No, I haven't. Not since we've been training, no.
Do you miss that? Do you feel like your body needs any green juice?
No, I don't. I don't really feel like I need it. It's almost like not really. No.
Okay. Cool.
It doesn't feel like it's.
And you're eating plenty of vegetables anyway, aren't you? Broccoli.
Yeah. Not a lot, to be honest. Only bits and pieces. Peppers, I eat quite a lot of. Onions.
Peppers are good. Quite thermogenic. Yeah. Broccoli's very good. It's actually a slight anti-estrogen.
Okay. Yeah.
Because one of the things that helps your metabolism is the foods that are high fiber foods. So vegetables have lots of fiber in that. Yeah. Helps keep you running fast and your metabolism running fast as well.
Okay, yeah, I could do more of that, to be honest.
Yeah, you might do you good to get a green drink in today as well.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
So today's your Zen day, Ben. Today is...
All right. So relaxation. Just the name of that acid one more time.
D-aspartic acid.
Okay.
Another supplement which I've shown you before, I don't know if you have got it, is which I use it's pretty good now and again, is Tea Matrix by MyProtein.
Okay, never heard of that.
Yeah, this is a very good natural test booster. It's got D-aspartic acid in it. That actually has also got a couple of other ingredients that increase protein synthesis, and I find my condition massively improves from taking that. Okay. If you can get that in you, if you can get some ginseng, get some maca, get Tea Matrix. On MyProtein, they do a bundle. We should be fucking getting a MyProtein sponsorship here, shouldn't we? Yeah. MyProtein do a testosterone bundle where you get a packet of creatine monohydrate, you get your D-aspartic acid, and you get a bottle of Tea Matrix, and it's like half the price. So you might want to look at that.
Okay. All right. Okay.
You're taking creatine, aren't you, non-stop?
Yeah.
Good. When it comes to carbing up and smoothing over, etc., some of that, when carbs bring water into the muscle.
Okay.
And a few weeks ago we spoke about potassium. You got a sodium and potassium. Too much sodium versus potassium makes you retain water under the skin.
Oh, it's the balance, is it? It's the ratio.
Yeah, it's the ratio. The more you cut your sodium down, the more your body's levels of sodium will stay the same. Again, push the body in that direction, it will go in that direction. So I wanted you to experiment a little bit with potassium, especially when carbing up. So you can get some today, have some potassium today, have some tomorrow when you carb up, have some the next day and see how you look.
Okay. All right then.
All right.
Okay, that's cool. All clear. Yeah, good.
Are you happy?
Yeah, I am, yeah.
Good. All right, I'll speak to you soon. Take care, Ben.
All right, thanks, Jaden.
Cheers. Bye-bye. Bye.